see me walking around, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. And I'm also paying attention. Amen?
Amen.
So now we're going to have our brother the sheep come up and give some remarks.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen?
That was a beautiful prayer he gave, wasn't it?
Amen.
Yeah, yeah. How many of us seen Cabin in the Sky? Remember that? All right.
That's a great movie.
Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum. Tasbih, can you come? Just please take my headphone. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate, I'd like to greet you again by the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum. The answer is wa alaikum salam. Tasbih, peace be upon you, and the same to you.
Thank you.
Amen. This is the greeting of Islam. We start to greet each other by peace. Peace, that means peace in ourselves, peace in the society, peace in the community, peace in the world at large. That message should be around all of us. As we start the beginning of the year 2017, this is excellent gathering. I like it. And I'd like to thank our president, Joe Godin, Junior, for his leadership, and also the friend in this executive committee, Reverend Coleman, Norman Coleman, and Reverend David Hankers. He's our neighbor in Venice Assembly of God, in Matthews Avenue. Our mosque is close to his church. We are neighbor, and we are a friend. And I'd like to thank him very from my heart. Why? In starting to launch this program, it's the revolution for culture and education. Okay. And I approached him. And I came to him, my friend David. Would you please help us to educate our community, especially in English, for our brothers and sisters who come from abroad? They don't know English. And he said, yes, I will help. And he introduced me to wonderful, excellent teachers, Harriet and Lenny in Bazaar. Can you stand up, please? Stand up, please. Harriet and Lenny is an excellent teacher of people. Welcome, please. Yeah. That's fact. And we have more than 100 women, they study English. And also, I am waiting for my friend and other guys also, the boss of the church, to help us for the men. Because we don't have enough teacher for brothers. We have a good teacher and enough until now, even today, two of them, they left because the pregnancy situation. Now, this is to continue also our reverend Dr. Rabbi Keith Thompson also. With us in the executive committee, in this council, and also the one who is that wonderful job, especially prepared for these programs and makes pictures and gathered the information. Reverend Louis Ruddles, he is there in the discount. And also, we work together also since we established our masjid, our mosque, in 1998. Our friend and the leader, and also depend on his close friend to us, Joe Thompson.
Right.
Joe Thompson is the president of the community council in 49 precinct. Thus he approached us many, many times. We were together for many years, almost 16 years or so. Brothers and sisters, friends, pastors, colleges, just God tell us, Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakara wa untha, wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu, inna akramakum 'inda Allahi atqakum. O mankind, we have created you from a male and female, for what purpose? And from different tribes and nations, to know each other. This is very important. This is the first from the book of Allah of God, Al-Quran Al-Kareem. To know each other and to spread peace and tranquility and the diversity in the earth, that to have cooperation and to help each other. Why? Because this is our teacher. When I speak here and I speak from my heart and to have this message, there is many brothers and sisters and friends from the Western society. They don't know the culture of Muslim culture. We are 1.6 billion. That's been 1/5 of the world. And us, all of these peoples, they are your brothers and sisters in humanity. Why? Because we are one from one source. We are transferred from one place back to Adam and Eve. خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى. That's been Adam is the first creation in the earth. And we come from that. And there is no superiority, white and black, and red and white. No. All of us, brothers and sisters, and children of Adam of Eve, that we are equals. What our prophet said, there is no difference between an Arab and non-Arab, and white person and black person, except by piety, the excellent good deeds and character. Thus, your character is what you raise your start in society, not your by physical appearance, not your by wealth, not your by language. Thus, we are equals. Thus, we said that, brothers and sisters, that we have to come together for the human, all human beings, security and safety, spread the peace, spread the prosperity to all people. Why? Because we have to be kind to others. It's not human that you are in a good shape and you have everything and the people are suffering around you. What kind of great? When you see the great nation not by tall. The great nation to make these people are like you. Like spread the peace. Spread the prosperity and the gift that you have. This is the gift from God. We have to thank God by what? Giving to the others what we are, what God gave us. If instead to build the bridge around the country and the nation to be in the inside the walls, make the bridges to the others, reach the other nations, the other peoples, and give the peace. And peace give them what you have. Why? Because God will give you more and more when you give to the others. When you deprive the other the rights and freedom and justice and equality, that God will prevent you from many, many things and rights. God subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal nas, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kunu qawwamina bil qist, shuhada'a lillah, walau ala anfusikum aw al walidayni wal aqrabin, in yakun faqiran aw in yakun ghaniyan aw faqiran, fallahu awla bihima. Or you have belief, be persistently standing firm in justice, witnesses for God, even if it be against yourself or your parent or your relatives. Whether one is rich or poor, God is more worthy for both. So follow not personal inclinations, lest you not be just. And if you distort your testimony, or refuse to give it, then indeed God is ever with what you do acquainted. That you have to be witness to others. There have to be justice to be fair. The fairness and the justice and the freedom and equality is the value of the humanity at large. In addition to that, this is the value of Islam and Muslims. Justice, we have to be just. Even though it against ourselves, our relatives, even though we're dealing with the others, the enemy, to be just, to give the freedom. Let me give the story that in the early time, when the governor of Egypt, Amr ibn al-As, his son, had a horse race with the one of the captive or the Christian young man. And the Christian young man, who won the race. And the son of the leader of Egypt smacked him. And he was so angry. He went right away to the Caliph to Medina in Arabian Peninsula across the sea, Red Sea, and came to complain to the leader of all Muslims. And he invited the leader of Egypt, Amr ibn al-As, and his son, and told him, مَتَ اسْتَعْبَدْتُمُ النَّاسَ وَقَدْ وَلَدْتُمُ مُهَاتُمْ أَحْرَارًا. When did you slave the people where their mother bore them free? We are a free man. They are free. How do you slave the people? How do you treat the people like this? And order the Christian young man to smack again the same thing, the same act. Not for revenge, but to educate that. There is no superiority. Arab for an Arab. Muslim for others. All they are equal in the sight of law, in the sight of God. Brothers and sisters, in this evening, it is a nice meeting. And I'd like it. We have to repeat again to spread these kind of values and qualities that we need. Justice is free, so important. Freedom and equality. And I'd like to thank all the brothers and the sisters who stand in every street, in every airport, especially to protest against the decision, the executive order from the president. When the many relatives prevent them, they have a green card and they have papers to prevent them to come to this country, how come that? And they tear and they destroy, they make their families separate here and there. What kind of human is that? Brothers and sisters, let us stand together in this kind of oppressions and to stand to make for those oppressed and to be fair for ourselves, our neighbors, and friends. The slave is gone. We are in 21st century. That 1930s and 1970s, enough or enough. That when I heard Joe Thompson just saying, there is a bathroom for the white, the bathroom for the black, and the seat for the black, and the other seat for the white. Why, how come? Who made these people are superior to the others? Who that? By what the laws? That we are in the sight of God, we are equals. Okay. There is no difference. Let us have these values and we have to practice them in our daily life. Thank you very much. And see you next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Thank you, Sheikh Amul. Part of our message tonight is to bring people together. And so many times we can be ignorant of things that we don't know. And we're grateful for Sheikh Amul. He's been a great inspiration along with the Bronx Muslim Center in this community. And so we stand with our brothers and our sisters to let them know we are all one and all together. Let's give God a hand clap tonight. We have tonight, I'm going to ask this because we're moving right along, moving very nicely tonight too. And thank God in the Bible, in Genesis, there's a scripture when Abraham went up to the mountain. He was about to slay his son. But there was a ram in the bush. Mm-hmm. Tonight we have a ram in the bush. We have a ram in the bush tonight. Our councilwoman, Vanessa Gibson, is here tonight. Give her a hand clap. She heads our public safety. She heads our public safety and works very closely with our mayor to make, and she watches over she's the kind of the watch woman on the wall of our police department. And so tonight, in the absence of our chief Nakuna, we're gonna ask Councilwoman Vanessa Gibson is gonna come and greet us. Come on, let's give her a hand clap as she comes.
Pastor loves to put me on the spot. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
And to all of my brothers and sisters in the Muslim community, assalamu alaikum.
Wow.
It is great to be here. To God be the glory. I am so grateful that God woke me up another day, and I am thankful for his grace and his mercy. It is great to be here, and I want to thank my good friend, Pastor Jay Gooding. Thank you so much for your love, your support, your friendship, and to the entire clergy council of the 4-9 precinct. God bless you, to all of the wonderful dignitaries, my brothers and sisters in Christ, to all of the wonderful members of the clergy. It is great to be here. And thank you to each and every one of you for recognizing the importance to come together. I think when you look at the past several weeks of what is happening in this country, I can honestly say that we're going to be a praying people, right? Yes. Because we know we need divine intervention on this country at time. Never in my entire life have I been more recommitted to my faith than right now, because I know God is my ultimate president. Can I say it again?
All right.
God is my ultimate president.
Yes.
And so I thank you. Tonight we are coming together to recognize many incredible public servants in our community who recognize that you may have a title in front of your name, but the title does not make you who you are.
Yes.
But you define the title, because you know that every title that we acquire, that we gain, that we earn, is ordained by God. And so I am thankful as council member for the 16th District in the South Bronx, in the communities of Claremont Village, Concourse Village, Highbridge, Mount Eden, Morris Heights. I represent a lot of communities. But I'm also equally as proud to chair the Committee on Public Safety at the New York City Council. And never in the history of the New York City Council has there ever been a chair that looks like me. Let me say that again. There has never been a chair in the history of the New York City Council that has been female, nor a woman of color, nor a person of color. Never, ever, ever, ever. So I am thankful for the speaker, Melissa Mark Viverito, for giving me the wonderful honor of chairing public safety 3 years ago. I'm in my fourth year at the New York City Council, and it is an honor and a privilege to work with the NYPD, the five district attorneys, the mayor's criminal justice director. We are doing incredible work in public safety. It's something that every New Yorker cares about. From every corner of every neighborhood in this city, everyone is entitled to be safe in our communities.
That's
it is an expectation that we demand, not ask for, but we demand. And in addition, I do all of the alternative to incarceration and detention work. I also do the anti-gun violence, cure violence work. So it is my responsibility to make sure we break down the pipeline to prison and the system of mass incarceration for many of our young scholars. We want to make sure that we are focusing on jobs and not jails, right? It's important. I say that because it matters. As members of this community, as people of all faiths, we must come together and recognize the purpose by which God has given us, right? Whether we have a title in front of our name or not, we simply have a responsibility to do our part to take care of our community. And if you look through the program, and I was wonderfully blessed to see and know many of this year's honorees, and when I look at the caliber and the degree of dedication of all of these honorees, I can only say God has truly been good to us in this community, because God has given us an incredible leader like Supervisor Pastor J. Allen Gooding, like all of our wonderful rabbis who are here, like my good friend Mr. Joe Thompson, who was just honored also this week at the New York City Council. We are grateful. There are a lot of honorees here that we are recognizing and acknowledging, but let me just say we all should always be celebrated, because it is because of you in this great community that we can celebrate where we are as a community and where we are as a people. We know things are not perfect, But when you think about how far that God has brought us, you can only say to God be the glory. And so we are called during this season, during this turbulent environment of divisive policies and executive orders and unnecessary tweets all over the place, we are called to recognize that through it all, we will overcome, right?
All right.
Just a few weeks ago, we celebrated and recognized the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and all that he stood for as a leader, teacher, and a preacher. And in the month of February, while the shortest month of the year, but we are recognizing the incredible accomplishments of African Americans throughout this history. And many of us, myself included, stand upon profound, broad shoulders like the Honorable Shirley Chisholm, like Harriet Tubman, incredible women and men that stood tall through it all, despite the odds. They said, we are destined to do something good for the betterment of our people.
Yes.
And we don't care what you say, we are not stopping until we achieve that victory. And when you think about that path and that history, and you think about our history, it's completely different. The struggles that our pioneers and trailblazers faced are a lot different than some of the challenges we face today. But that doesn't mean that we don't face challenges, right? Because we know as long as our schools continue to not provide sufficient education and academic enrichment to our children, that God is not done with us yet.
Right.
We know that as long as we continue to struggle for real affordable housing in our city, God is not done with us yet. And what I really love and am so pleased about in this administration, and in particular our NYPD Police Commissioner, James O'Neill, who is not only one of the incredible public servants in this city, but he's a friend of the Bronx. He loves the Bronx. And this administration has incorporated clergy like never before. Everyone has a faith-based initiative. Everyone has a working group that's full of members of the clergy from all different faiths. Just last week to this day, to be exact, 500 of us were gathered in the 4-4 precinct at the Latino Pastoral Action Center with Commissioner O'Neill and many, many leaders in the faith community, many of our precinct council presidents and members, and we had an interfaith celebration. Because we recognize that we may have different faiths, but we serve one God and we have one common purpose. And that is to live out our full destiny according to our Lord and Savior and to make sure that we do everything possible to serve our brothers and sisters. Yeah. And no matter what faith, no matter what you call your God, we have a common purpose. We have common priorities. And we simply want the same things. We want safe streets, quality schools. We want access to greater health care. And we want affordable housing. We want to enrich the opportunities for our next generation of young people. We want their lives to be better than our lives have been. We cannot just talk about it, but we have to demonstrate it through our actions. And when I say that, I mean it. We have to demonstrate it through the work that we collectively do. Whether you're clergy or not, if you are a resident in this community, you owe it to this community to do good by this community. And I often say a lot of times, people always ask, well, how do you do all this work? As an elected official, you're expected to be everywhere at all times of the day. And the one thing I say about this position, right, is that it's not a 9-to-5. It's not just a job, right? Not for me. It's a calling. It is a calling, right? The Bible says, for many are called, but few are chosen. And I truly believe that God has given me this incredible opportunity to serve his people in elected office. And I have a term limit. I have an expiration date. So the time in which God has put me here, I want to have a profound impact. I want to make sure that at the end of the day, the community that I represent is better than how I got it. And by doing that, I want to invest in our schools and our parkland and our open space and creating jobs and opportunities for young people so that they're not defined by their community or their neighborhood or their zip code or their ethnicity or their socioeconomic status, but they are simply defined by being a child of God.
All right.
I believe in that, and I don't just say it, but I provide it through my office, through the interns, through summer youth, through all-year youth employment. We at the City Council are doing our very best to invest millions of dollars into the programs that matter. I'll let you in on a slight little secret. Tomorrow, I'm going to be joining the mayor and many of my city council colleagues because we are going to announce the creation of the first ever office to end gun violence. Yeah. So we are very excited. An office to end gun violence. And Pastor Jay knows this very well because he also works very closely with Standing Up to Violence. And we have many grassroots organizations like Bronx Connect and Save Our Streets, Guns Down, Life Up. These are grassroots organizations that focus on the root causes of gun violence. Taking a gun out of someone's hand and replacing it with a job, with a diploma, with an education to say, young person, you don't have to live this life, but you have options. A lot of times our young people don't feel that they have options. It is up to us to allow them a chance, an open door of opportunity, just as the doors have been open for all of us, right? So I am so passionate about this. I could talk forever about my passion for young people because I truly believe in them. I know they have great potential, and I will never give up on them.
All right.
I know that many do, but I will not give up on young people. And so I ask all of you, all of our community residents who are of good faith, to continue to do the work that you were doing. Continue to be encouraged and know that it is having a profound impact on this district, on this community. We will not let an election change nor define our values nor our principles.
Right.
But if anything, we will continue to reaffirm our commitment to each other. Because you know what? At the end of the day, we answer one God. And he is giving us an opportunity. And a lot of times, all of you know, and I truly believe, whenever there is a setback, it is God's preparation for a comeback. Right? And so I know that this is just temporary. I almost lost my voice because we're going to so many rallies and demonstrations because we have to reassure our brothers and sisters that they should not be in fear, that they are our brothers and sisters and we are going to have their backs, just like someone had our back, right? So now it's a call to action. What will you do to make a difference in your community? What will you do to stand up to those that refuse to accept change and those that want to stand on the side, right? We call them bystanders. I call our folks upstanders. Let's do some work. Let's roll up our sleeves and let's be prepared. Because unfortunately, in this climate, we will need to fight like never before. We're called a sanctuary city for a reason, because it means that we as a city will fight tooth and nail to make sure that we don't roll back all the progress that has been made in this city. And we have a mayor, we have a speaker in the city council, and all of my colleagues, and I especially want to recognize my colleague who's always, always being a champion, Councilmember Andy King, and State Senator Jamal Bailey. And our speaker, I was just with the speaker, Assembly Speaker Carl Hastie. So many of my colleagues that are doing this work, and we're doing this work together. So I ask you to please be encouraged. Please do not give up. There are young people that are destined for success. All they need is access and an opportunity. They need someone to believe in them. They need someone to look beyond their circumstance and say, you can be a success. We've done it. All of you have done it. We're all successful in some way, whether you've been honored tonight or not. Now it's young people's turn. Now it's the next generation's turn. Now we have to allow them an opportunity to be the next leaders. We're not doing this forever. I'm not doing this work forever. And I certainly recognize that in this work, I want young people, our young boys and girls, to look at me, and I want them to see themselves. I want them to realize that beyond it all, they can be successful. So if I leave you with anything, as all of our community residents and people of good faith and goodwill, thank you for what you have done. Thank you for what you are doing. And I look forward to what you will continue to do in the spirit of fellowship and in the spirit of partnership. May God bless you and keep you in his mercy and grace, and may heaven smile upon each and every one of you. Congratulations to all the honorees, and thank you to my good friend. I love and appreciate you. God bless you.